Hello, my name is Myron Richardson, Executive Director of Flanner House of Indianapolis, and I'm standing here today with Tavion Callahan, who is a student at School 44 who lives in the Flanner House area. Say hello, Tavion.
Hi.
Well, you know, friends, we continue to need your support and solicit your support of Flanner House programs. Currently, we're looking at some serious facilities issues here. Our programs, quite frankly, have outgrown the facility that we're in. And that's a good thing. And so we're looking at trying to construct a new facility on Martin Luther King Jr. Street. We're conducting a feasibility study right now to determine if we can do that. We're envisioning a facility that will have a library in it. It'll have social services space. It will have a community room. It will have a new early childhood education facility attached to it. That really represents the excellence of this agency and the services that have been provided over the years. So we really want you to think about that and think about ways that you can support us in achieving and getting this done. The following, you're going to see some highlights of some of the programs at Flanner House from 1898 till now. So please enjoy the video presentation that will follow. And we continue to solicit your support. Thank you very much.
Much like Flanner House of 1898, Flanner House of today is still a sanctuary for those who want to empower themselves, empower those around them, and improve their overall quality of life. With a greater emphasis on multi-generational services, today's Flanner House has emerged as a much-needed resource to those in need. Innovative educational programs, bustling literacy, charter school, nationally accredited child development center, a vibrant summer enrichment program, and recently being named a Center for Working Families site by the local initiative Support Corporation are just a few of the ways that Flanner House continues to recognize and respond to the needs of Indianapolis's residents.
You know, it shatters me to think about what would happen if Flanner House wasn't here for me and my family. Like I said, at the age of 8 was when my mother and father separated. So as far as the other guidelines, you know, a male role figure in my life, if it wasn't for Flanner House, I wouldn't have had any in my life.
For people of color, if Flanner House wasn't there, it would have been a hard swing, because the thing of it is, you had to come up with X amount of dollars for a down payment at this time, even to get in a halfway decent house. You understand what I mean? When I said a halfway decent house, they had some, what we used to call, shotgun houses or whatever it was around the place. And for people with maybe one or two children, might have been fine. But, you know, what about guys like me? I had 6 kids. I had to do something with them.
The Flanner House was not there for so many members of the community. I don't know how they would survive. You know, we have to even look at our outreach programs, from the prosecutor to the library to housing to just everything. Flanner House, I always said we take care of the whole family, every human need that a person has, from food, shelter, and clothing. If you can't get it at Flanner House will refer you.
Flanner House Elementary Charter School is very unique because it also provides wraparound services that supports not only our students but our parents as well as the community. It has, for example, the library services that we have here. We're supported by the Indianapolis Public Library. We have the Senior Citizens Program. We have the GED program. We have a Skills to Success program also. There's also the Marion County Child Support Division that is also here located on the campus as well. And I think one of the most important things that the community needs to see is that this is at no charge. The charter school, we are supported by public dollars. We do not charge a tuition for our children to be here. But in order for us to sustain all of these good wraparound services that are being useful to our children and to the community, we need funding. We need funding. We need support from our businesses. We need support from our government. We need support from all of the community in order to have this institution to continue to keep progressing and moving forward. And that's going to take dollars, it's going to take spending, it's going to take financial support. So any support that can be given is much appreciated.
If Flanner House were not there, I'm not sure that I'd be where I am today. All of our family benefited from the learning and the role modeling that we got from the teachers and instructors at Flanner House, from the extra or remedial educational programs that they had. If I had not had those, then I could have taken a different course in life and not be where I am today. I have really benefited from what Flanner House offers in the past and what I know they'll offer in the future.